You okay, Sheba?
Are you okay?
Oh, they hurt her. They hurt her bad, Dr. Stone.
Go get some. Oh.
Dr. Stone, I see your friends have fallen down on the job.
You know, Sinister, do you really think it's going to take all five of you guys to take me on?
What are you saying, Dr. Stone?
Well, I can see it now. The headlines in the newspaper. Decepto and his partners defeat Indiana Stone while their leader watches like a chicken.
A chicken, Dr. Stone. I don't need any of these people, and I don't need your God, all right? All right, Slime, I want you to take the worshippers back to the camp, and I want you to tie them up. Oh, and by the way, don't forget to cover them in raw meat. I want the animals of the forest to have a feast tonight.
Come on, let's go.
Why are you so mean?
Come on.
Lots of meat.
Raw meat, Sinister, that's low for even someone like you.
Oh, thank you. You are too kind, really you are. But I must say, I am sad to see it end.
Really?
Well, of course. I've rather enjoyed chasing you around. Kind of like a game of a big cat in an itty-bitty little mouse.
Really? Well, there's just one thing you need to remember.
What's that?
You haven't caught me yet!
Is that the best that you have, Dr. Stone? I mean, maybe we should change your name to Dr. Paper, because you are so weak and easily torn. How is that, Dr. Paper? Get up, Dr. Paper. I'm ready for you.
I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength.
Is that one of your quotes from your Bible, Dr. Stone?
Well, yes, actually. You know what? It is. And if you'd bother reading one of these things instead of trying to destroy them, maybe you'd learn a little something.
Blah, 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 Dr. Stone. I want you to prepare to meet your friends. Stone, I'm going to get that Bible from you if it's the last things that I do.
Give it back!
Dr. Stone, I want you to meet a friend of mine. We're going to do a little trade, if that's all right with you, Stone. I'm going to give you this snake and take your Bible. Yeah! I finally have it. It's all mine.
Decepto, I see you've got the rope, but where's the raw meat that we were supposed to put on these prisoners?
Well, you see, the thing is, I got really hungry, and I ate it.
Oh, well.
Okay, that'll do it. Got it. Okay. Oh, I'm stuffed. Eating all that meat, I'm hungry. I'm gonna go take a nap. I'm gonna go sleep. Good night.
Good night. You know, that sounds pretty good. I need my beauty sleep.
Yeah, looks like you could use it too.
Hey, that sounded like an insult.
The both of you better be quiet. I need to get my sleep. I see you.
Mommy.
Oh, it's too early. I'm not ready to get up.
Oh, it's just the alarm. Oh, it's morning, guys. Get up. We gotta do some chores. Come on, get up,
no,
get up,
not
keep
chores.
Moving, come on.
Early
jumping jacks, let's go. Hey, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Why do we have to do chores? Okay. Right. Captain Jealous, you need to polish Sinister's boots.
Oh, no way. I polished them last time, right after he stepped in something. Oh.
Why is it always whining with you? Okay, fine. Jezebel, you polish the boots. You iron his clothes.
Oh, and what are you going to do besides boss us around?
Well, I've got plenty to do. Primarily, I have to make sure Sinister's food is top quality. You know, we can't have him eating unspoiled, tasteless meat. No, we've got to have moldy bread and maggot-filled steaks for Sinister.
Well, I don't want to iron no clothes. Come on.
So what you're trying to say is you're going to eat while we do chores, and I don't think that's fair. I don't think he's right.
I'm working hard with it.
I'm not doing the boots.
We got to get these chores done. Let's keep it quiet.
Well, what are you going to do?
What am I going to do? I have to do all the hunting of food for Sinister, get all his rats, and then I got to go find Bibles in the jungle, and then tie up the prisoners, and...
Nice job, Decepto. You let them escape again.
How does this keep happening to me?
I don't know. You're pretty good at it.
Okay. It's going to be okay. Just don't tell Sinister. That's all. Just make sure don't tell Sinister, and it won't be a problem. I don't think he'll notice.
Now, tell me, when you tied them up, I saw you doing it, but did you tie the ends of the rope together in a knot?
Hold on. Don't tell Sinister what?
Let's see.
What's just so funny?
I was just telling them a joke.
Okay, you were telling them a joke. I'm a funny guy. Why don't you tell me a joke?
I don't think you'd like this joke.
Sure I would. Go ahead and tell it. I'm a good guy.
Knock, knock.
Who's there? Where is they going?
Not the prisoners. Don't tell Sinister.
That is not fun. That's not funny. Decepto, where are my prisoners?
They're gone.
They're gone?
Yeah.
Decepto, I have warned you enough, all right? This time, you are going to pay!
Okay. Let's be reasonable. Let's look at the bright side here.
The bright side?
Yeah.
What is the bright side? The prisoners are gone.
Oh, yeah. I got nothing. I don't know.
Decepto! Look what you've done! Look, the only people that can help me, they are unconscious!
Okay, again, very sorry about that. Guys?
Decepto?
Okay, don't hurt me.
Decepto?
Okay.
I can't hurt you. You are the only one that can help me. Now we have to come up with a plan with just you and me. Please, come this way.
That's Dr. Stone.
Guys, can you
got it.
Lend a hand there.
It's okay. I got him.
Dr. Stone, are you okay?
Yeah, I think so. I'm going to be fine. But Sinister, he's got my Bible again. We've got to get it back before he destroys it.
Hello? What about me over here?
What happened?
Well, after they took you guys away, Sinister and I had a little run-in, and well, it didn't go very well for me.
Oh, don't worry, Dr. Stone. We'll get them, and we'll get that Bible back.
That's right, Dr. Stone. They're going to wish they never messed with us.
Hello? You guys, remember me? The other part of the fellowship, the one that is hurt?
Delbert.
Could use a little TLC, please?
Yes, Delbert, come on.
You're okay.
You guys don't care about me?
Yeah, we do. Okay.
Delbert, you all right? Okay, you know what? Sinister may have won the battle, but with God, we're going to win the war. Let's go get that Bible back.
All right.
All right.
I'm with you.
With you.
All right, let's go.
Deceptor.
Yes.
I need you to listen very carefully, all right? Normally, you don't listen. I don't know what the problem is. You just don't listen, all right? So listen up, please.
Listen.
There are two things that we need to remember, right? This Bible cannot fall into the hands of the worshipers. Do you understand?
Got it.
All right. This second thing, this is important. Two or three times now, the prisoners have gotten away. Do you know why? It's because you have used a slip knot, okay?
Okay.
A slip knot. That means they can slip out of the knot, okay? All right,
yeah,
so here's the second rule.
Okay.
Listen, all right? Hello? Are you listening?
Yeah, I'm listening.
Okay,
yes,
all right.
Yes.
Don't use a slip knot.
Okay.
Okay. Do I need to say that a little louder?
No.
When you tie up the prisoners, don't use a slip knot!
Okay, I got that. Okay.
All right, here's what I need you to do. I want you to take the Bible, and I want you to destroy it, all right?
Yes, I can
I have
that.
I have an infected toenail on my toe. It's green and pussy, and I have to go chew it off, all right? It's got little curds in it every stage. It's just yellow. It's hurt.
Okay.
It's very painful.
Okay.
You don't understand. I got to take care of this.
Okay, I can't mess this one up. I got to destroy this Bible. Okay, maybe I'll chop it in half. Okay. Oh, well, maybe I'll turn it this way. No, I think the long way is best. That way I don't have to hit it so many times. Okay, here we go. Who is it? Who's there? I saw somebody. Heard something. Is there anyone over there?
My toe still hurts. Deceptor, what is all the commotion, Deceptor? What is going on? Be still, you're making it worse. You're losing your helmet and everything. All right. What's going on? What is it? What? Dubai? Don't lose the Bible. Is that what I told? What did you? Great, wonderful. But, Deceptor, I told you not to do that. Now look. Okay, just forget it. All right. Breathe deep. Count to 10. It's okay. I've seen people for this. It's okay. All right. Listen to me. All right. Now we have to go find slime and the rest of the rebels because we are going to need their help. All right. For us to find stone, we need all their help. Let's go.
So, Moses, what are we looking for this time? Because I can find it, I know I can. How about like a piece of Noah's Ark? Yeah, Noah's Ark. Wait, no. I got a better idea. The burning bush. Let's find the burning bush. I know I can find that.
Delbert, none of those artifacts are from the book of Daniel.
Samson's right, Delbert. Those aren't from the book of Daniel. I mean, we're not going to find an ark in the middle of a jungle.
You guys never like any of my ideas.
You know, Delper, it's not really that we don't like him. It's just that you never have any good ideas.
Yeah.
Well, what's the difference? You know, if you guys aren't going to listen to me and my ideas, I don't even know why I should help you look for artifacts. I'm just going to sit over here.
Will you please? Okay. So we can look for something?
Yeah.
Ow! Ow! Oh,
oh no.
Oh! Oh!
What now?
Oh! I got bit by a snake!
Delbert,
oh.
Would you stop?
Oh! It hurts.
You
so
did
bad.
Not get bit by a snake.
How do you know? You didn't feel it?
Look!
Look, I see feathers, but what are those?
Those are, they look like talons, you know, claws from a bird.
Moses, do you think this could be another Bible artifact?
Well, let's look in the Bible just to make sure.
Let me see. Delbert. Feathers and talons.
Okay.
Delbert, what are you doing?
Is it the feather that tickled you?
Oh, I think you guys will find this very, very interesting.
What is it, Moses?
Well, it says here that immediately the word was fulfilled against Nebuchadnezzar, and he was driven from among his men and ate grass like an ox. And his body was wet with the dew of heaven, till his hair grew as long as eagle's feathers, and his nails were like bird's claws. Oh. I'll bet you that's what this is.
Moses, I don't understand. Why did the king's hair grow long as feathers, and why did he grow talons? I don't understand.
Well, it was because he didn't give God credit for what his accomplishments.
He didn't give God credit.
Didn't give God credit. What?
It sounds like he didn't give God credit. It sounds like he was a wise man.
Sinister! What are you guys doing here?
I see you escaped from my friend the snake.
And you are so lucky that Decepto, no brains, was the one to tie you up. Lucky.
But now your luck's run out.
When are you guys going to get it? Because you just don't. It's not luck. It's God. You know what? God's the one that protects us because we have faith in him and believe in him.
That's right.
You know, this fantasy world you're living in is going to get you hurt.
You're the ones who are going to get hurt.
Samson, quick, pick up the feathers of the
talons. It's all over for you.
Trying to eat you?
Oh, no. At least it wasn't about the pickle again. No, but it was pretty disturbing nonetheless. You know what? I need somebody to tell me what this dream means. Go get some of my wisest men. Go get them and so they can interpret it for me, okay?
Yes, King.
Oh, I hate those giant pickles. Oh man.
King, I have brought you two of the wisest people in the kingdom.
All right. I had another bad dream, and I need you to tell me what it means this time. You don't have to tell me what the dream is. I just need you to tell me what it means, okay?
Tell us your dream, O great king, and we will interpret it for you.
Yes, king, tell us your dream, and we will interpret it for you.
Well, all right. Here's what my dream was. I dreamt that I saw a tree, and this tree grew so high that the top of it reached the very heavens. The leaves were beautiful, and it had wonderful fruits growing on it. But then, this holy one came down from the heavens and said, "Chop this tree down to its stump. Let him be wet with the dew of the heavens, and let his mind change from the mind of a man to a mind of a beast, and let a period of 7 years pass over him. Now, what does that mean?
Oh, I think that he should tell you first.
No. You are going to throw first.
I'm not going to go first. Yes, you clearly know more than I do about it.
All right. Are you telling me you can't interpret my dream?
Wait. I got it. Okay, great king. Your dream, what it's saying, great king, is that you should go out and do some yard work around the palace. Because frankly, it's looking a little,
yard work. I was back before. The grass is very tall and the trees need
bigger
to be
than my hair.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yard work? I'm not doing yard. Ariok, isn't there anybody who can tell me what my dream actually means?
Well, Daniel did help you that one time.
Daniel, that's right. You know what? You go get Daniel. Take these two bozos and have them go do yard work.
Yes, King. Get out of here.
Yard work. King, I made this kingdom everything it is. It's great, and I made it that way. I deserve all the glory for it. Not doing any yard work.
King, here's Daniel.
Daniel, maybe you can help me out. I had another dream. Now, I don't need you to tell me what the dream is. I remember it. I just need you to tell me what it means this time.
God, he'll tell me what your dream means.
All right, here it was. So I dreamt, and there was this tree, and the tree reached all the way up to the heavens. It had beautiful leaves and amazing fruit and everything, but then this Holy One came down from the heavens and said, chop this tree down to its stump. Let him be wet with the dew of the heavens. And let his mind change from the mind of a man to the mind of an animal. And let 7 years pass over him. Daniel, what does my dream mean?
Well...
No, Daniel. Don't worry about it. Just tell me. Don't be anxious. Just tell me what it means.
Oh, King, if only this applied to your enemies. See, you are that tree. You've grown great and strong. Your dominion expanding to the vast corners of the earth. But you'll be taken from your kingdom. You'll live with the wild animals. You'll eat grass. And it will be 7 years until you acknowledge that God controls all kingdoms and appoints who he wishes to rule them. O King, please repent from your sins.
Yes, well, thank you very much for that interpretation, Daniel. Ariok, give Daniel a gift for his service to me. Take him away. That's fine.
Yes, King.
What? That can't be the meaning of my dream. Why, I made Babylon all that it is. It's great and mighty. This whole kingdom is wonderful, and it was made for my glory.
King Nebuchadnezzar, to you it is declared. Your kingdom has been removed from you. And you will be driven away from mankind, and your dwelling place will be with the beasts of the field, and you will be given grass to eat like cattle, and 7 years will pass over until you recognize that the Most High is the ruler of all mankind and your kingdom.
What? That's ridiculous. I'm never going to move. Something in my throat. I'll never be moved. Oh, what's happening to me?
What was going on here? What's going on?
I don't know, sir. All I saw was a little thunder, a little lightning, and then...
They were gone.
Gone?
I don't know, but we've got to get after them. If Stone and his group start getting artifacts together, they will open their museum and ruin my plan.
Oh.
Let's go get them. Follow me. Let's go. Let's spread out. Let's look for them. We will find them.
Dr. Stone, I don't understand. How come the rebels and Sinister didn't go after us?
I don't think they saw us.
What do you mean they didn't see it? It was right there.
I don't think they saw it. I don't think they saw us. I think when we pick up the artifacts, because we're believers, I think God shows us this wonderful thing.
Huh.
Yeah.
Huh. And I think with that, they don't believe. And because they don't believe, God won't show it to them.
Makes sense.
Okay. Dr. Stone,
makes sense.
What do you think this is?
Delbert, stop! Stop! Oh. I've told you 100 times, never, ever touch anything close to an artifact!
What was that? What was that?
I don't know what's happening.
Uh-oh.
What's going on?
What is that?
You hear that?
Watch out, Delbert!
Delbert! Delbert!